Hi, I'm Gerry from Gerry's Craft Room, and in this video I'm going to make another easy art journal page. I start with making a background with Distress Oxide inks, a great ink that I have been using a lot this year. I add the ink straight to my work surface and dilute it with water. I use the Distress Sprayer for spraying, a tool that I purchased not long ago and that I absolutely love. I apply several layers and I dry it in between the layers so they really layer and don't mix. By the way, I added the products I used in the description box for you, and if you're new here, don't forget to subscribe. Now, while you watch me adding the ink, I want to tell you something really exciting. At the end of January, I will be hosting a 3-day Stamping Without Stamps challenge. And in the challenge, you are going to make tags, cards or journal pages using ink and different mark making tools. I'd love for you to join, and I want you to be prepared, so I have added the homework or challenge pre-fun sheet in the description box for you. This is going to be so much fun, so I really hope you will join this challenge. Now make sure to tell your friends, the more people join, the more fun it's going to be, and if you share on social media, use hashtag #StampingWithoutStamps to get the word out. I will be adding more info about this challenge in the tab Community here on my YouTube channel and also on Instagram. I put a stencil on the paper and spray some more water to create more texture. I let it set a bit and then blot. The result is very subtle, but it adds nice to the layers. After drying, I'm going to add some color with the same stencil and the dark green ink. By the way, if you feel inspired, I always love to see your makes, so don't forget to use hashtag Gerry's Craft Room when you share your work on social media. And I add some more with the blue ink. Now I add the Nouveau Expanding Mousse with a FabScrap stencil, a fun new product that I had to try. It is different than the Nouveau Embellishment Mousse, and you will see that in a bit. I take away the bits that went under the stencil with the tip of my knife. The expanding mousse is a bit thicker than the embellishment mousse, and I think it's easier to apply it with a plastic card. I sprinkle on some white embossing powder with a craft spoon to get a snowy look. And then I melt the powder and make the mousse expand. The mousse gets a bit of a bubbly look and I like it, it's really great texture. It's also different from other products that you heat and get bubbly. That is air that comes under the product and this mousse really expands and it doesn't flatten out when you touch it. Now I will add some more texture. First I spray water drops and this goes great with the Distress Sprayer. Just squeeze a little and you get different size drops. And then I'm going to sprinkle on my embossing powder and heat set it right away. As long as the water is wet, the powder will stick and when you melt it, it will stick to the paper. Now I add the printed sentiment. I always like to use different fonts to print my sentiments. I thought it needed a bit of a darker color along the edges. And as a finish, I'm going to add some Nouveau Vintage Drops. They have a matte finish and go perfect with the distress and mixed media look. I hope you liked the video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching!